You have, maybe realizing so or not, have really keyed into the center of this. And you're articulating it very well. So I want you to listen carefully to the next question. So you keyed in on brands and profitizing and money. And that that organics cost a little more. Think of the trade-off of this. We know pesticides cause cancer, goiters, your lips to fall off. We take all these medications that warn you you could have sudden death, but you might have an erection from hell. And so with all of that in mind, pesticides versus organics, if you think about the hospital bills of some tests running $250,000 to look at that goiter from all that crap you ate over the years, for that all that money you saved, you just blew it in the hospital. Versus organic people who tend to live longer, feel healthier, and are more clean. How do you get that message through to people that really it's a short-term cost savings, it's a long-term devastation to you and the rest of the planet?
How much do you weigh?
Otherwise, height proportion, she's so off frame from everybody else we've shot. It's almost creepy.
Is that true?
I feel like I'm so tall.
You are. You just grew 4 inches, 6 inches. So you're 5'6" now, right? Just trying to get, she's got some nice lacy things on, at least knee high up. Because we were shooting at everybody else lower. You want to stand on a little ladder? Oh, this would work. Hey, this is huge. Jesus Christ.
Does she really need that much?
No, we're going to find out.
Dude, she's like, she'll be monstrous.
Well, it's just the green.
Why am I?
It's the green screen. It's
just... I felt like
Jesus,
I
was... step up.
Jesus Christ, she's like 7 feet tall.
Oh yeah, now she's King Kong.
Like, what the fuck?
Every day on the side.
Well, it's all green screen. Actually, now I can make that work.
You can make the higher one work?
Are you kidding?
Don't she genuinely check? Her head's at, like, higher than the green screen.
No,
what do you mean?
No, that actually, you can pull that in frame.
Thank you.
Yeah. You can pull that in. That, she's fine. She's low enough for that.
Really? Now, would it balance it out a little more if I flip it the other way? So it's,
are you serious?
It's not. You haven't seen the shot yet.
Wait till you, I'm set up for the shot. He's not shooting her nose there. Plus, she's up
so
light more, that's going to light her up more.
How's that? Because she looks a lot more luminous now.
Illuminated.
Oh, yeah. I can see that shine now in her face. So, Matt, how does it feel being shorter than your date today? Would it be better on this a little louder? Would that be safer?
I think it's safe.
Like this? This?
Oh, God. Jeez.
No, that's more on the table.
Come on, it's a DeWalt.
I don't know. I do this thing how, like, just.
Oh, man. You want to come? We'll do that to my house.
Oh, sure. Why not?
Serious, can I blow that?
When?
Seriously, I need one of those two.
I can ask you, he's gonna want a backup.
I was thinking,
you should have money in your
pocket.
I don't want you.
Is that doggy stuff? Your lips doggy stuff? Okay, can we roll or no? Cousin Ed, can I see your hair? Yeah, on this one she does go off the cuff, so that is the problem.
That's why.
Yeah.
Gosh, you're so fast. I thought you had it done already.
Wait, so does that mean all the stuff we did before is like unusable?
No, no, we'll use it. But we're asking.
Are you that short?
Yeah. This is too tall, so now we've gone to the opposite extreme.
He just wants your pretty legs.
Now we're getting to the bottom of it.
Be real, I mean, if you want to know what's going on right
now. You are such a piece of work. Honest to God.
Well, you wouldn't be laughing so much if it wasn't true.
No, I'm laughing because sometimes you just said something off the wall. It just comes out of fucking nowhere. It's like, huh?
You like it.
Where did that come from, Garfield? Wow.
Psycho, I think. I think you're psycho. Hey, what did, speaking of psychos, what did Riker want? Yeah.
He wanted to know what you wanted, if it was him on camera,
yeah,
or if it was the music leader.
Well, we can talk about that, too. So Megan can handle the licensing stuff. I wanted to get him down here too. So he can get down there.
He's up.
He's
up.
He's going to
call him.
Okay. He's a kind of gentleman since I went to his house.
He was nice to me. He didn't have some beef with me.
Oh, yeah. Because I hung up on him and no one's ever done that before. He was kind of pissed about that. And he was shocked that I had the balls to show up at his house party on Sunday. But I did. And I said, the reason I hung out, Ralph, so he told him. And his girlfriend thought I was perfectly in the right and just applauded me in front of him. Yeah! Are you trying to look like Rebecca of Sunnybrook Farms the way you're pulling the hair like that out? Do you need like a little basket and tow her to follow? Yeah? Okay.
I think you're crazy or questioning my costume.
All right, so do we put her on lower, on that lower one, or we just go back to where we were?
Okay, I mean, I'm ready if we're ready to go. She's in frame there, and she's a little chopped on the bugle.
The fuck is beeping?
Stop that.
That one's fine. They're fine. Yeah, I think pretty. I mean, if you can go up like a fraction on the main camera, but you got enough headroom there. If not, we'll click. Oh no, that's too high. That, yeah.
Right,
yeah. There you go.
Okay, we're still rolling. So,
making a difference.
How?
Good question. How would you answer that? How can I make a difference?
So, making a difference, the first thing, obvious / not so obvious, is coming from within yourself, making the choice right now, starting now, just making the choice to, one little step at a time, what to buy at the grocery store. It could be little, maybe you don't have to go full blown, donate $1,000 to a bunch of organizations or whatnot, but what strawberries you buy, what lotion you buy. Just start being conscious. Start talking about it. Stop feeling self-conscious about trying to be organic and trying, like, what people will think of you, because in the reality, it's the new fad. So I guess just starting with yourself and talking about it with others as much as you can. And social media is such a huge aspect now for what you can say.
I don't know if you know much about my background, but I've been part of helping Rainforest since I got here when ABC brought me here 30 years ago. And so I've met a lot of dignitaries, diplomats, and other boneheads. And I was invited to go to the emergency summit they're having December 9th in Paris on global warming. In fact, they were rushing me to get the film done because they wanted me to play it before the UN General Assembly. Until they realized I was going to tell the truth. That the footage we shot with the ambassadors that they told us we can't use, I said I'm going to use anyway. Because they admitted they've known about this a long time. That's not the point I'm driving at. So they said, can't come anymore. And so we released this information that the UN basically violated their own charter of humanitarian rights and global warming and stuff like this. And within 2 hours, those people on the internet knocked shit off my network so hard AT&T called the FBI. True story. We live in such a world right now where we're malicious with animals and we're destructive with people in every way, shape, and form, electronically and otherwise. Why does this need to change, and why should we get rid of the current people who are screwing it up?
Why does it need to change? I think you just answered that.
But they didn't hear what I said. They're only hearing you, so somehow you got to wrap this into what you're saying, because they may not ever hear that clip unless we write it in as part of the script that I read. They may never hear what I said that prompted your response.
Okay.
So now you just had a dynamite load of information. Oh, by the way, I broke diplomatic protocol because I called the ambassador at 6 in the morning, except I didn't call him until 8:30. And I emailed him too many times. He emailed me 7, I emailed him 9. It was all bullshit. It was a lie. They were just trying to throw it under the bus to make me go away. And I said, no, we're not going away. In fact, I'm coming to bring you down. So how to stand up to world leaders and empower people to make a vote, make a decision, and do their part to make a change.
We're done.
So,
okay, good.
We're done?
No, I said we're done. We're done.
Okay. So an example of how we have changed can come a little bit forward with coming against huge monopolies and businesses, maybe this is a little setback, I'm not sure. But I do know in like 1960, there were over 60,000 slaughterhouses in America with meat, slaughterhouses. Now, there are only 13. That means that all the meat, chicken, or two main people, and I'm pretty sure those one or two main people are in the Senate. Who do you think can tell them what to do? Nobody. Not you, not me. It'd take a lot more than just one person. Tens of thousands of people releasing videos trying to get inside these slaughterhouses, but they have so many strict laws that you can't even go inside, can't even ask questions, nothing. And for us to say that, like, we have these, well, it's America's best government on the planet, blah, 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 these people with billions and billions and billions of dollars, that they don't have secrets, that these crazy businesses like McDonald's was like the number one buyer of apples in America, tomatoes, not just meat, like they're huge. And to think that we know everything about it is naive. And then to think it's okay that we don't know everything about it is absurd. But to talk about this, I feel like it's almost pointless, because this is just the negative stuff that makes us feel bad. But I guess we can learn from this and come forth from it. But then we have to talk about how. And I think it was like Thomas Jefferson who said, government, we shouldn't fear the government. Government should fear the people. That's a good government.
That was actually Dwight Eisenhower.
Really? Are you sure?
Awesome.
Yeah, 1950, he said it. He was a colonel in the army, was it?
Yeah.
And just before he got elected president, he warned the American people, beware of the military. It was. I'm sure you could Google
military
it.
Military-industrial complex.
Yeah, the military-industrial complex, I think, was the actual quote. Could you, do you have a second you can check that? I'm almost positive it was Dwight Eisenhower.
But maybe there was a different quote, because I'm pretty sure. Maybe I'm wrong.
What was the quote?
It was, fear not the government. I don't know. A good government is not feared. They fear their people.
Oh, that one I don't know. Okay. I thought you were talking about that.
But either way, power is in numbers. Regardless of the thousands of zeros these people have behind in their bank accounts, there are so many of us who feel this way. And in the new modern day of age where we can connect to each other, there is not a more prime time to come together and overcome this than now. There are revolutions happening every single day. Take your neighboring countries, for example, like Syria. And it's scary and it's bad, and we don't want America to come to that. But America being as strong and powerful as it is, with all the good people there are, it's not going to. This isn't a war of guns. Blood. This is just a war of health, wellness, and safety. And I think the more people know about it, the more we'll be closer to succeeding in a happier, healthier nation. Yeah.
What haven't you said that you want to?
Is there an area that you have feelings about or passionate about that you want to support? Get out to vote, make a difference. Shoot your dictators.
I have another meeting at the house.
Yeah, I don't think so. I couldn't come
back. Did we get promo?
What?
You gonna do a quick promo?
They did together.
Kind of a joke.
Oh, they're joking.
Do you want to do a series?
That would be nice.
You do one series.
Yeah.
Series.
Two series.
What is it called?
Small farm, no, Moretta's Rainforest Should Not Die.
Moretta's Rainforest Shouldn't Die. .com.
.com.
To learn more about what we're talking about, get a little bit more insight to why we're all here, visit Moretta's Rainforest Should Not Die. .com.
Now give me one with your name.
My name is Jackie Benet. More about what we're talking about is that Moretta's Rainforest Should Not Die. .com.
Fabulous.
Hey. Okay. Thank you.
Oh my God, Carter.
Oh, I thought you were getting a
forget to get us your headshots and bios.
We'll do.
We're
gonna go.
Keep it rolling.
Yeah. See you guys.
Yeah,
bye. Bye. Thank you.
Is there anybody else
coming
over in there? Just you and I don't.
I think that's it.
Okay. Okay. Oh. You and I might be out of here on time. So you can do your promos, right?
I'm with it.
That's really self-evident. So Oli seems to do, I think there's a lot of people in India and he might be able to have a surgery.
Are you
going to
get Oli on?
I could say a lot about this, but I don't know like exactly what I want to say.
Well, the whole Exxon Chevron thing was pretty heavy. That would be good. A lot of people suppressing information for years.
Sure.
And likely we'll get away with it unless somebody pitches a shitstorm. And even then, they'll probably still get away with it.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, that's
sad.
Heart
attack.
Exactly, yes. That's what happened with the Warren Commission. Everybody was dead within 6 months.
I worked with the Dalai Lama's family, and Dalai Lama's biggest brother started Free Tibet movement. Oh, he had a stroke, and then his son falls to work. He gets run over, and then the second son starts.
Shit happens. It's mysterious. All in a short string of time, a lot of people can vanish. That's why I always say, say your prayers. Everybody, don't eat crap. Corner right in my backbone really did not feel good.
Those two are Those two are funny together.
Yeah, they are. They really seem like they're fun together. She's actually very articulate. For someone fresh out of high school at 18,
she's way smarter than he is.
I didn't say that. I actually think they're a cute couple. I still don't know that she's really 18.
I'm kidding. Sorry, I couldn't get away with
that. That's alright. Yeah, I busted my chops in front of everyone.
By the way,
I saw you guys threw me in front of a bus. Still sorry, having issues walking in.
You
know.
Step back one. Actually, let's have you stand on that little thing. Okay. Oh, okay. Never mind.
No sunshine when it's dark. Is it warm in here or is it just me?
A little warm.
Now, so sorry, I'll try to reschedule, thank you. Oh, well, I just got a note from Jennifer's here. Ouch. Are you hearing back from any other people's that...
I gotta put you in touch with Hunter Richards.
Okay. No, I don't.
No. Both of you, I guess. Hunter. But in regards to this, there's a company called Go Green Culture.
Wait, while you're correcting, I gotta make sure I'm ready.
It's rolling, ready.
Go.
Okay, I'll come and relieve you in a moment where she's doing her problem.
Hi, I'm Maria
Lisi,
and joining us is Jonathan Hoffman.
Hi, from great individuals, experts, people who are leading in their fields, to find out information about what's going on, the real story behind the rainforest, and what big companies, the world leaders are doing to sweep the numbers under the rug, to put a veil over the We'll start that one.
Hi, my name is Maria Lisi. Join us at MirageousRainforestShouldNotDie.com to find out more information about this very important and urgent film, the saving of our planet, especially in regards to rainforests, which provide us with oxygen, plants and animals that have cures for different diseases and are able to provide health benefits. You can also see clips from a wide range of people, experts, leaders in their fields, people passionate about this cause, to find out more information and educate yourself. Educate yourself about what's actually going on, to educate yourself on what you can do as an individual to recycle, to reduce waste, to be more environmentally friendly and sustainable so that we can work together to save our Earth.
Cool. Yes, sir. Anything else you want me to go over? I think it's good. Yeah. Is there anything else? Did you already do the interview then?
Yeah, for the most part.
It's just profound.
No, we did some stuff as far as some questioning about,
Is there anything else you want to say after listening to it?
Probably.
Is there anything we didn't talk about?
I could do, like, the degree Celsius thing. So.
Yeah, whatever you think you missed.
So there are a lot of studies about climate change and the world getting warmer, and something like we've already raised temperature-wise 0.8 degrees.
only thing that we all have a reason to come together for is that we all have the same plan. And if we're pushed over the edge, I've heard this story before, that people actually intentionally pushed us over the edge so people would wake up and realize what was going on. So is there something, anything else in terms of all that, like deeper level? Like I've heard a lot of general kind of stuff, but I haven't heard anybody talk about wake up everybody, aliens might be real, the government might be lying to us, these corporate interests might be attached to old monies and oil families. Not so much conspiracy, but fact based on history that's been manipulated to change. Just as we're witnessing now with Exxon and history being manipulated by our own planet, what would we have to say about other things?
We're definitely destroying our planet Earth, and yeah, maybe we could go to Mars and live there, and the whole thing could happen again. And Mars doesn't especially seem like a super hospitable place. It's pretty barren, and there are a lot of really wonderful, beautiful things on Earth. And I haven't been to a rainforest. I would like to, but maybe they won't exist soon. And those need to be protected. They're gorgeous, wonderful places. And why not stay on a planet that has so much beauty? And there is some speculation that maybe with this battle to save the Earth, that'll tie all of humanity together and we'll fight one big enemy together. But why take it to that point? Why not protect what we have now? Nature's a gift. It's not something that we're really entitled to or can expect to be there forever. Whenever I feel an earthquake here in LA, I'm in Nebraska originally, so we don't really have earthquakes. But to me, it's a reminder that the Earth is real. It's a living thing. And when you see news stories about different disasters, it's another great reminder that the Earth is real and it's fragile and you're supposed to protect it. The Earth gives us so many things, from energy to food to a place to live. And what do we do in return? Just chopping things down, digging holes, blowing things up, killing animals, killing plants, polluting the air, polluting the water. It has to stop, it has to change.
Well, where are we at with that other disc?
I think I have it all.